Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to install the current MongoDB version on Windows 10. With that, we will also create a sample database. Let's start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type MongoDB and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible. Click on it. Now go to the products menu and click on it. Here in different MongoDB products are visible. We want the open source one, so I'll click on community edition. Now go below. Here it is, download community. Click on it. Now go below. We have reached the community server section. Go below. And the current version is visible for Windows x64. This will work for Windows 10. Okay. This is our installer file. Okay, keep it as it is and click download. Now the download will start. 713 MB. Let's wait. We have downloaded the exe file. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The setup started, click next. Accept the license agreement, click next. Setup type, I'll directly go for complete. Keep the install MongoDB as a service checked and the following also run service as network service user. The service name is MongoDB, which is fine. Data directory is the following. Our MongoDB will get installed here. This is the path. And this is the log directory. You should remember this path. In case of any errors, you can directly check the logs. Click next. Install MongoDB compass. So it is a UI for MongoDB. I won't install it. Okay, I'll uncheck this. Click next. Click install. Now the installation will start. We have completed the installation. Click finish. Now let us set the path. We installed it under C drive, program files. Here it is MongoDB. Open it. Open 8.0, bin and copy this path. Minimize. Go to start, type environment variables. Click open to open it. Now go to advanced, click environment variables. Under system variables, go to path and double click. Go to new, right click and paste the same path. Okay, click OK, OK and the last OK. We have set the path. Now we need to also install MongoDB shell. Why? Because MongoDB shell, that is MongoSH, is used for interacting with MongoDB deployments. So we will quickly install it. Go to the browser again. Here in type MongoDB shell and press enter. Click on it. So this is the official website and we have directly reached the shell section. Here it is, MongoDB shell download. Go below and the following is the shell version and it is for Windows 10. You can see Windows 10 plus. I'll change this to MSI. Now I'll click download. The download will start. It's only 45 MB. Let's wait. The download is complete. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. Now the MongoDB shell setup started. Click next. Unselect this so that you can install MongoDB shell for the entire system. Now this is the path wherein MongoDB shell will get installed. Click next. Click install to begin the installation. We have completed the MongoDB shell installation. Click finish. Now let us verify the installation and start MongoDB for the first time. Go to start, type cmd, click open. Now I'll type mongod space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Now 8.0.0 is visible, that means we successfully installed MongoDB. Now minimize and we will start MongoDB shell. Go to start, open another CMD, that is command prompt. Type CMD and click open. Now guys, type MongoSH. This will begin the MongoDB shell. Okay, here it is and the versions are visible. We installed both of them. Now let us directly start with creating a new database. First, I'll check the default databases using the show DBs command. Show space DBS, press enter. These are the default three databases. Now I'll add a new database. So I'll directly type use space database AmitDB. Okay, so you can add any name here after use. When I'll press enter, it will be written switched. I pressed enter and we are inside our AmitDB database. Now guys, let us quickly create a new collection using the db.create collection command, and within this you need to add the collection name. I hope you know MongoDB includes collections and documents to store the records. So within this you can add a new collection, add any name. Let's say I want to add a students collection, so I'll mention student inside. Press enter. Now query okay is visible, that means we successfully created our first collection. Now if you want to add documents to it and want to learn the complete MongoDB, refer our free MongoDB tutorial. The link is in the description of this video. Thank you for watching.